everyone, the Guiding Gamer here, and today I have a in-depth endgame guide for swag and sorcery. I'm gonna go over a few tips and tricks, and I'm gonna go over how the endgame works and the best way to play the endgame, a few meta builds, and yeah, just for the one few people out there that wanna know how you play this game at the highest level. It's not that terribly complicated because me and a few other people have already done all the work for you. So, right. There's a few builds here. I'm gonna name the builds first. There's a legacy meta build, which is not possible to obtain anymore. There is a current meta build, and then there is a current meta build which excludes the endless mode. So in case you don't know, you unlock the endless mode once you've beaten the final boss on Underground City. Then you unlock this endless mode where you can upgrade the endless mode every single time. You complete it and it becomes a little bit harder. It has the materials for some of the best items in the game, and so on and so forth. You can see I'm level 536, so that's quite high. I haven't seen anyone higher than this. I don't doubt there is someone out there crazy enough to go higher than that. And I have every single recipe in the game. So, but there's a build without this, so if you're getting into Endless, like you're on that borderline into Endless, the current meta build is what you're going for, but you can obviously substitute that with transitioning from without Endless meta into Endless meta, basically. Right, my characters, my main squad is pretty high, as you can see. So I'm going to discuss the legacy meta build first, which is the unobtainable one, just to get rid of that straight away. Which basically involves... Okay, so here's the strategy. The strategy is to focus on health, regeneration, and money. So basically, we don't even care about stats. We don't even care about... like, you know, high damage item or even high level item for that matter. We just care about regeneration, money, and health. And here's how that works. So there's an item in the game that used to have a bug, basically, which was called the skin and leather. The bug was that it's supposed to only craft for 1 to 60% regeneration. But if you read this item, at the beginning of each move, the hero recovers 100% of the damage he or she suffered since the previous move. What does that mean? Well, that means if you don't get one shot, you'll stay at 100% health all the time. That was deemed to be a bug. I got lucky enough to craft 3 of these. That was a ton of crafting. I did it all on stream. It took a while. But you can't get these anymore. We'll get around that. Don't worry, you'll still get your 100% regeneration. There's a workaround. A item you can use for your weapon is the Muscle Man, which every time a character hits an enemy, the player gets 180 gold. So here's a thing where I get a little bit ahead of the main amount of people playing this game. You won't actually be using this because you need to use a regeneration item here instead, because otherwise you'll die. So this will not be a part of the current meta. Bandage Jacket will be though, which gives you 200 gold on hit. And Hunter's Helmet will be as well, which can get up to a 200 gold per hit. I only have a 199 here. And then a Scarab Invasion, where we try to stack health. So how does this strategy work? Well, it works in the way that basically we just try to stay alive and get gold. And then what do? Well, if our characters all have high health, get a lot of money, and can only die to one shots, otherwise they heal full in the next round, or consecutive shots, I should say. The strategy basically becomes that we try to get as much gold as possible, and we use the gold on our characters to level up their stats. So stats on weapons and stuff doesn't even matter, because we get all of our stats through other means. Right. So now I've been through, like, you know, the legacy meta build. What is the current meta build then? Well, the current meta build is you want to get skin and leather, which is all the way down here, which primarily is crafted through they got rid of intermediate crafting, so you don't need to do intermediate crafting anymore, but it's primarily crafted by running These three? No, sorry, my bad. These, these two. That's how you primarily get those. This one to get the leather, and this one to get the fangs. And you're gonna be needing to do a lot, because you wanna get these ideally. For the meta build, you don't need to get it that high. You can get away with getting it to 50%. As you can see, it goes from 10 to 60. You can get away for meta build, current meta build, by getting this on only 50, and I'm gonna explain in a second why. That's the only item you need from this blacksmith. Then if we go into the hunting lodge, so here comes in how we get to 100. We use the tech crossbow free, because this can give us another 50. So the reason we only need like 50 to 60 on the skin and leather is because we can get the rest of the 50 from this one. But obviously if you get a 41 of this and a 61 of the other one, that works too. You only really care about 100%, because more than 100% doesn't do anything. Yeah, so that's about that. Otherwise than that, you just want to focus on getting stats like health and stamina, basically. Those are the most important stats to increase your health artificially. Okay. Okay, so the other items for the main build that is current meta would be the Hunter's Helm, which you can get up to 200. But as you can see, this is endless items. That's why I have included a non-endless build as well. Also, by the way, I'm going to link all of these in the description so that you have a list of what you need to get. I realize all of this might seem a little bit confusing and you need a little bit of reference to go over all of this. Okay, getting on through to the next one is the bandit jacket. Let me just find it. Is that all the way down? I think so. Bandit jacket, there we go. 200, this only requires standard resources. You can get these without endless. Okay, that's it for the generation items. And then I'm going to show you basically what you need to get as well is a scarab invasion. And you want to craft a lot of these, because these give 50 to 250 HP. And they can give 1 to 30 stamina. So the best you can get is 250 HP, 30 stamina, 30 stamina. That's the absolute best you can get. And that just increases the health pool so that the chance of you dying from a single hit is lower. You could also go for a money jinx that can proc stamina. But the thing is that basically one stamina equals about 2 health, if I remember correctly. So this is basically 140 health plus 60 health plus 60 health. So that's less than 250 health plus 60 health plus 60 health, best case scenario. So I wouldn't recommend using the money jinx. I see some people use this. I don't think it's worth it. I think you should use scarab invasion. Yes. Okay, so what do you do if you can't really use the meta build because you don't have the last one unlocked? Well, the without endless meta is basically skin and leather 60%, which is in here, remember, all the way in the bottom. This one has to be 60%, and that's because if you don't want to use the endless ones, you have basically only one other option, and that one only scales to 40. So you need one at 60% here. Okay, then you need a tech crossbow, but the level 1 version, which still scales to a 40 and uses not endless endless materials. And from there on, it's pretty much you want to use the space thing. Let me just find it. Oh, you want to use the wolf hat, basically. There we go, that one. And then you want to use the bandit jacket, because that one is actually free of endless things. Then the same with the scarab invasion. Okay, so that's a bit about the metas. So as you might have figured out, this is a lot of material. So what you can do, and what I do, is I have my main squad fight the Endless, while I have my other squads farming for materials that I need for some of the other things. So that way I have very little downtime. Basically always farming what I need. Okay, another tip is that not only can you upgrade your things in here by just, you know, like training them, you can also actually give individual attributes like strength, agility, intelligence, and stamina. And that a little less expensive. Another thing is, remember when you craft items that you need basically 100% for the crafts in order for them to be really good. So keep in mind, you have to do that. And then also, for the final tip is, rename your characters into what characters have the most of a certain stat. So I have strength, stamina, and agility. This one is infected by strength, this one is infected by agility, and this one is infected by intelligence. Okay, that's about it for now. If you liked it, then liked. If you really loved it, then make sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon. Comment there in the comments below, Reddit, Twitter, and Facebook. And I'll see you all in the next video.